I start by listening to the customer. I try to formulate some ideas of what I think it is. And, oh, I heard the water heater's not working and the range is not working. All these two-pole loads circuits were not working. So my first thought was, okay, they probably lost a leg. So that's what I decided to come look for first, which, you know, so I came out here to this panel, took a look at it, look in this panel, and tested up at the main breaker here. I put my meter on that breaker just to make sure I had good voltage coming in. And I did have 240 volts from line one to line two. And I tested from each line to neutral to make sure I had 120 volts, and that all checked out. So that ruled out the service. A lot of diagnostics is about going with what you think is the issue and then ruling it out. And so I ruled that out. That's not the issue. So next thing I did was go inside to the panel on the inside of the house. I opened that up and I found that there was no power at that panel. Came back out here. This circuit breaker was off, but now I need to figure out why. And so we'll take a look at the panel inside and I'll show you why. With this new panel here, this is the one that was presenting the original problem when I got here. There was no power to this panel. And it turned out that the breaker had tripped due to overload, because what we have is a few different appliances plugged into one 60 amp breaker. So we have, you know, a washing machine, a dryer, a water heater. I'm not sure where these other loads, but there's two 20 amp breakers and a 15 amp breaker on this circuit. And that's just, it's too much. If it all runs at the same time, let's say the heater on the dryer is on, the washing machine's on, the water heater kicks on, good chance that's what caused this to trip, on overload. Can't do a full repair right now. They really need an upgraded electrical system, new panels, upsized panels, all that. There's a lot of expense surrounding that. So we did what we could to return the circuit back to service, let them know that they have to be careful how they use their electricity. They can't just run everything at the same time, run things one at a time. And that's really the best we can do at this stage. And then if they decide they want to do an upgraded electrical system, then we can come back and we can do that for them at a later date. All right, thanks.